Hello YouTube. What I'm going to show you today is how to cover depron sheets or depron parts with standard covering which is used for balsa airplanes. I use this mostly on control surfaces, but also I have two airplanes that are fully covered. So I'm going to show you today how it is done. First of all, I have some scrap covering here which I'm going to use. This is very handy. Masking tape, you'll see why. And I'm using ordinary iron because I don't have a modeling iron, so I'm going to show you. And heat is set up on silk, so it's a little bit above a half of synthetics, well, a little bit below half, all around half of full travel of or full heat. So let's go. Masking tape, why? Well, let me show you why. You need to remove from the covering that piece. It's usually very hard to do it. So what I'm going to do is just take a piece of masking tape, actually two pieces, and just glue them here in the corner like this and unglue them. See, this unnecessary part can be easily taken off, and let's put the covering on this piece. Let's assume this is aileron, and using the iron starting from the center, just iron it easy, nice. From the center to the edges. Okay, that's it. Now I have to cut off the extension. Just usually cut a little bit around like this. Just leave some covering for the edges to be available. There. And cut it like this. Remove the corners. You won't need those. So you can easily sweep. You can easily put this covering film on the corners. And final one. I'm going to leave this one here. Right. And now just all also from the center, just iron these edges. One by one. Again from the center on the longer surfaces or longer edges. Okay. there. That's it. One side is finished. Let's do the other side again. Some masking tape, very helpful for removing protective plastic from the covering film. Oops, this one didn't get. Yeah, and you always know that this part where this protection was is the one that should stick on your surface. This is the one, this is the part where the glue of the covering film is. So let's start from the center again. Just make it slow and easy. It's always good to iron from the center to the edges. Now, full surface is ironed. Press a little bit. Great! Let's do the same job for the edges. Cut off what is not needed anymore. The reason I used this big piece of covering film, it is just a scrap left from my previous build. Okay, let's do the corners. Cut them out so you can bend easily. And the last one. And do the same procedure as, let's say, on the front side, right? Just nice and easy. Here we can start from the center and do close this edge very nicely. Oops, I haven't finished it right. Do this edge. And the final one. So you all have iron at home, you don't need to buy modeler's iron, but it would be much easier because it is smaller than this big one. But since I don't need it so often, I can use just home iron and do it at home. Now, if you notice that your control surface or whatever you are covering is a little bit, let's say, bent on one side, all you need to do is heat up an iron by step or two, let's say like this. Iron heats very fast, and just do the little cover, do the little ironing with a higher temperature on that side, and it's quite straight now. Why? Because this covering film is when it's heated, except that it's glued, it also shrinks Let me demonstrate. I'll do a little higher temperature on this piece of scrap and you'll see how it, I hope you're gonna see it, how it shrinks. And I don't know if I'm going to manage doing it like this. And if I measure it here, you can see that this end is a little bit shrinker than this end, which hasn't been heated. So that's the basics. And just to show you, this is one of my RC airplanes, and you can see that I covered all control surfaces with the same one, with the same covering film which is used for balsa planes. And I'll show you on the pictures some other of my models, like FT Racer from flight test, which I built, and it is fully covered with gray covering film. And my 3D model Funtana, which is covered with pink and yellow. So don't be afraid to cover your foam planes. Sometimes it's much better than just paint it, because this covering film gives you a sort of stiffness, and it's very hard to break now this piece of foam, because covering is from all the sides, as you can see, and just helps and prevents from breaking. Yes, it can be, let's say, damaged, but on the other hand, all you have to do with something like this, heat it a little bit, and sometimes it will be enough for quick repair. Usually this piece of foam wouldn't stand this type of breaking, and with covering film it is quite how to say, it's quite difficult to break. And it's a good thing when you land or when you have surfaces that are like this one, really close, and during landing usually it is, this elevator is up, and if you catch a high grass or something with this part here, it would break. But when it's covered with covering film, be sure it won't break. Okay, thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel if you like my videos, share them, and see you next time. Bye!